So I just got finished cooking up a massive update to the Winhance project. Now, if this is your first time hearing about Winhance is a utility that I created, which is a Windows enhancement utility. And it's basically just a PowerShell script with a graphical user interface that allows you to optimize and customize Windows 10 and 11. So the way it used to work is you would just come over to GitHub, then you can just copy this launch command, also just ensuring that you can run scripts on your machine. Then you would open Windows Terminal and then paste the command and press enter, and that'll download the script from GitHub and then run it on your computer. Then once it was launched, you'd have access to these options. You could install basic software, you could remove Windows apps, but there was no way of adding them back onto your system once they've been removed. Then in the optimize screen, you had some Windows security settings, and you had different sections like privacy settings, gaming optimizations, and so on. And then in the customize screen, you also had some settings related to customization. But the issue with this that some of you pointed out is you don't have any control over what exactly gets applied. So for instance, if I hover over the tooltip for Explorer, it just applies a whole bunch of different settings, and you have no way of selecting the settings that you want to have applied until now. So I've completely refactored Winance from a PowerShell script to a proper C# application that can be installed and run on Windows. The app now also has its own dedicated icon and its own dedicated download page. So you can find a link to this page in the description below. To download it, straightforward, just click on the download button to download Winance. And as you can see, this will only work on the 64-bit version of Windows 10 and Windows 11, since it only has a 64-bit version. I'm trying my best to develop Winance to also work on Windows 10 for you guys that are using LTSC versions of Windows, and that's not going to go over to Windows 11. But the main purpose is to get Windows 11 a better operating system because of the support that's going to end for Windows 10 at the end of this year. So once you've downloaded it, you can just run the installer. You can see that Chrome is saying this is not a commonly downloaded file because it's a completely new file that exists on the internet. And the application is going to be signed, so this should happen less and less in the future. And remember, the code is fully open source. It's on GitHub. Anyone who understands code can go and review the code to see if there's anything that shouldn't be in there. So I'll just run the installer here. Then you'll get the install mode. I'm going to install it for all users, accept the license terms, and then just go ahead with the install. I already had it installed. That's why I got that prompt. I'll create a desktop shortcut and then just continue with the installation. And then once it's finished, I'll also launch it. So this is the first look at the new Winance. So let me take you through all of the changes, starting with the software and app screen. The first thing you'll notice here is that there's a legend telling you what these status indicators mean on the screen. And you'll see there are new status indicators telling you if an app can be reinstalled or if it can't be reinstalled. You also have an indication of if Winance is removing apps from your computer. So if this is your first time seeing Winance, or you didn't watch the previous videos, Winance doesn't just remove the apps from the computer, it also saves a script and a scheduled task on the PC that runs every time you start up your computer. So even if something gets installed via a Windows update that you didn't want to have installed or that you selected to be removed at one point in time, it's just gonna remove it again once the computer starts up, because the script is dynamically generated based on the items that you select when you remove them using Winance. So you can see that on this computer, currently multiple items are being removed via the bloat removal file, and then OneDrive is also being removed. The other script that also gets saved is the Microsoft Edge removal, but I don't have that applied on this system right now. So you can also see the tooltip tells you to check all the items you don't want on your PC, even not installed items. So even if the icon currently has a red indicator telling you that it's not installed, but you don't ever want that app on your computer, then you can select it as part of the removal process to include it in the script that removes items from the computer. Then you'll see I also added a search bar here, so you can search for items. Let's search for something like Edge, for example. And then you'll find the checkbox for Microsoft Edge. And then you have two buttons here on the right. Now, one of these are completely new. You can install selected items, and then you also have the remove selected items button that was moved from the bottom of the panel to the top here. Now, another thing I did in the Windows Apps and Features section is I just created categories on this page so you can see which are Windows apps, which are Windows legacy capabilities, and then which are optional features. So you can see, for example, a Recall is a Windows optional feature. The old legacy Windows Media Player is a Windows capability. And that's different from the media player that you have as a app on the computer, the new music player app. Now you can see some of these items can't be reinstalled or re-enabled once you remove them. So be aware of the fact that some of these items can't be reinstalled once they've been removed, as clearly indicated by these installable and not reinstallable indicators. So just as a quick demo of this section, I'm going to select the camera app and Copilot and then Microsoft Store as well. Then let's just select the Windows legacy capability. We'll select WordPad and then Recall as well. So I've made my selection now, and then I'm just going to click on Remove Selected Items. You'll see the following items that will be removed. Do you want to continue? Yes, I want to continue. And now we also have a status indicator down here because these tasks now run asynchronously, so you can go ahead and use the app for other things while it's busy doing this. So you can see the success message here. These items have been successfully removed and their status also changed in the UI here. Now let's say that I accidentally selected something that I didn't want to uninstall. Let's use the Microsoft Store for example. Then you can just go ahead and select the Microsoft Store and click on Install Selected Items. Click on Yes to install the selected items. And then it's actually going to go ahead and download and install this application via Wingate. So as long as it can be reinstalled or re-enabled, you don't have to worry. You can reinstall it on your computer if you accidentally removed it. And part of this process is it's also going to update this bloat removal file that's created dynamically with the items that you selected. So the next time you start up your computer, this item won't be removed again. And as you can see, the Microsoft Store is installed again. If I do a search for it on my computer, I do have access to the Microsoft Store and I can use it. Now, if you scroll down on the software and apps page, you'll get to the external software section. And this is also a completely new section or a reworked section with a whole bunch of useful applications. This is mostly stuff that I install on new computers or that I thought you guys might need on new computers or a fresh install of Windows. So then you can just select whatever apps you want to have installed on your computer, then click on Install Selected Items, and it's going to install that application on your computer. Now you will see that in this browsers section here, there is no Microsoft Edge because Microsoft Edge is part of the Windows apps that's included in the Windows apps and features, and you can install it from this menu here. So applications that come with Windows are generally inside the Windows apps and features screen, whereas external or independent software is included in the external software section. Now I'm going to be showing you something very useful and very cool at the end of the video. But before we get to that, let's move on to the optimize screen. So in the optimize screen, you can see that you also have the search bar, so you can search for settings quickly. So if I search for something like power, for example, I get to the power settings. But let's start from the beginning. You can see we have the Windows security settings with the user account control notification level. That's the same as before, but now you have toggle buttons in these different sections here that gives you more control over the settings that you want to have applied on your computer. So you can see there's a bunch of settings that you have access to on this optimization screen, and it's going to be the same for the customize screen. But the point is, you now have more control over exactly which settings get applied on your computer. Now, the other thing I added here is if you hover over these items, you can actually see which registry key it sets. And if it sets multiple registry keys, like the Send Diagnostic Data one, you'll see all of the registry keys that it's going to change on your computer. And it also has a recommended value, but you can take the recommended value with a grain of salt because what I might deem as recommended on my computer, you might not deem as recommended on yours. So, for example, I have camera access turned off, but if you're someone who uses your webcam constantly, then you'd probably want to have camera access on. So just as a test, I can show you if I enable camera access and we go to privacy and security and we go to camera access is turned on. And if I open Winance again and toggle it off and open camera again, it's toggled off. So this is just a quick example to show you that these settings actually do get applied on your system. But I'm not going to go through every single toggle button with you in this video here. I want you to go ahead and download Winance and test it out for yourself. If you don't want to test it out on your main computer, use it in a virtual machine or some old computer, but I want you to go and download it and use it for yourself. I will just mention the different categories here. So we have gaming and performance, you've got Windows updates, you've got power settings where you can select a power plan for your system, balanced, high performance, or ultimate performance, and then you've got control over some other power settings on the computer as well. We've got Explorer optimizations, notification optimizations, and then sound optimizations. So you can see in the notification section here, I've got none of these settings enabled, and obviously that's because I want to have notifications disabled. You can't just run through this and enable every single setting, because then you're actually doing more harm than good. You should look at the setting and determine, do you want that enabled or disabled on your system? Now, if I go over to the customize section, the setup is the same. You've also got a search bar to search for settings. There's now a Windows theme section where you can choose your mode from a drop-down menu between light mode and dark mode. In the previous version of Winance, this was a toggle button, but a combo box like this makes more sense. So I changed it to that. And then you've got some settings for the taskbar here, for the start menu, and then for the Explorer. That all work with these toggle buttons, so you can decide if you want to have it enabled or disabled. But now let's move on to the thing that I think is the most useful and really cool feature that I added in this update. Now you might have noticed at the top of the Winance window here, there are some new icons. So you can save a configuration and import the configuration. I also have a button to toggle the Winance theme that was there before, and then a donate to support development button, but we'll get to that in a moment. So what I want to show you here is this feature that you can save a config file and import it. So this was my chain of thought when I developed this config feature. You can download and install Winance on your computer. Then you can go through the different settings and sections and apply them to your computer the way you want them. So let's say as an example for this video, I'm happy with the settings that I've got applied currently in the optimization screen and also the settings that are applied in the customize screen. Now, if we move over to the software and app screen, before saving your config file, you need to select the checkboxes for the applications that you want to have checked every time you import the config file to Winance. So as an example, let's say that I'm going to select all of these capabilities that I want to have removed from a new computer, or if I do a fresh install of Windows. So I'm just going to deselect the ones that I want to keep, which is Edge, Terminal, the Store, Notepad, and Sticky Notes. I'll keep the Windows Media Player as well, and then the subsystem for Linux. So I'm just going to select these checkboxes. I'm not going to install or remove them now because I'm trying to save a config file. I'm not trying to actually remove them when saving the config file. The same with the external software section. You can now go ahead and select all of the items that you would normally install on your computer if you do a fresh install of Windows, or if you set up a new computer for the first time. So as an example, let me just select Thorium, 7-Zip, Nilesoft Shell, Start All Back, and then I'm not going to go through the others. I'm just doing this as an example. So I've now selected the checkboxes in both the Windows apps and external software that I want to have selected when I import the config file in the software and app screen. I'm confident that the settings I have applied in the optimized screen and the customized screen is exactly what I want to have applied on my computer when I import the Winance config file. Now I'm going to click on the Save Config button. It's going to prompt me for a save location. I'll just save it on the desktop, and then it'll tell me it saved the config file successfully for these different sections of Winance. So now I'm going to go ahead and change some settings, which will also make the changes to my computer. So I'm going to change from dark mode to light mode. It also prompts me if I want to change the wallpaper. I'm not going to change the wallpaper now, but my Windows theme has now changed from dark mode to light mode. Let's also uncheck this option to launch to this PC when opening File Explorer. So if I open an Explorer window, it now opens to quick access instead of this PC. Then in the optimized screen, let's just put the user account control to moderate. And let's also change the power plan to balanced. And just to verify that these changes are working, if I go to the control panel and power options, the balanced power plan is now set on my computer. Then in software and apps, let's deselect all items and then also clear the selection in the external software. So now let's go ahead and import the config file. So I'm going to click on the Import Config button. I'm going to select the Winance Unified Config. I'm going to open it. Then you'll get this window asking you which sections you want to have imported from the config file. So we've got the Windows apps, external apps, customization settings, and optimization settings. And then it tells you the amount of items that's going to be imported. Now, I've already thought about changing this section so that you have more control over the subsections in each of these categories and what gets applied in the subsections. But for this release of Winance, this is the way that it's going to be working. So I'm going to leave all of these selected and then click on OK. You can see it just changed from light mode to dark mode, and now it prompts me if I want to change to the default dark mode theme wallpaper. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to click on no because I like my wallpaper, And then it's just going to do another refresh on the system. And then you'll see the unified config has been imported successfully. So I'll just click on OK. And now you can see the checkboxes that we had selected here. They're all selected again. And the ones we didn't have selected, they're not selected. So all of these installed apps, we deselected those. And in the external software, we also have the items that we selected here. So for the software and apps section, you import the config file, and then you still have to either install the selected items or remove them according to what you want to do. And the same for the external software section. The optimization screen and the customize screen, their settings are applied automatically. So you'll remember that I changed the user account control notification to moderate after I saved the config file. And when I imported the config, the user account control notifications are set to low again. One of the other settings we changed here was the power plan. I changed it to balanced. And when I imported the config file, it applied the ultimate performance power plan again. So once again, if I verify that in the power options, it is indeed the ultimate performance power plan that is enabled on the system. Then if we go over to the customize screen, we already saw that it changed to dark mode because it prompted us to change the wallpaper. But here you can verify as well. I am using dark mode now, where I set it to light mode after saving the config file. And then the other setting we changed was to launch to this PC. We disabled it. And then we verified by opening the Explorer that it opened to quick access, and now you can see it's opening to this PC again. So I hope you're understanding the point I'm trying to make here and how much time this can save you. With Winhance, you can install it on your computer. Then it is going to take you some time to go through all of the settings and all of the available options that we currently have in Winhance, so you can get it set up the way you want it. But once you've spent that time and you save your config file, the next time you reinstall Windows, you can just install Winhance again, import your configuration, and have the items that you want to have removed, the checkboxes, you'll have those checked, and you can just click on a button to remove them. The same with the external software. The items will already be checked for you. You can just click on install selected items, and it's going to install those items on your computer. And that should save you a lot of time setting up your computer after a fresh install of Windows, or if you're setting up new computers for clients if you work in IT. I used to be a computer support technician, but I'm not anymore. I'm now creating content full-time here on YouTube, as well as on my website, and then developing these apps. And I've got a lot of stuff planned for the future, and I'd appreciate you supporting my content and the applications that I create. And with that being said, this is where we get to the support button that you see in the UI here. So if I click on that, it's going to take you to my page on Ko-fi in your browser. And with this platform, you can either donate monthly or you can donate a one-time fee. There are some preset amounts here, but you can add any amount that you want to donate. And this directly helps me create more and better content and improve the apps that I'm working on. With the previous version of Winhance, which was the PowerShell version, a lot of you guys have donated already, and I really appreciate that. Those donations helped me to get Winhance to the point that it is now, but now more than ever, I'm relying on your support to continue creating content full-time and to develop free software and apps that help you get a better experience out of Windows. And whether you've already donated to me or you're gonna donate to me in the future, I just wanna say a massive thank you, because it really helps, not just financially, but also because it's a really good motivator and an incentive to keep on grinding. So go ahead, download Winhance, try it out for yourself. Let me know what you think about it down in the comments of this video. And if you encounter any issues or errors, just go ahead and create an issue on the GitHub page. I'm going to be more active on there starting now. Up until now, I didn't really pay any attention to the issues that's been popping up because I've been working on refactoring it from a PowerShell application to this C# version. And although some of the issues might be the same from the PowerShell version to the C# version, I'll now pay attention to them and fix them as they arise. But with all of that being said, thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate every one of you, and I want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. I really value your support, and I'll see all of you guys soon.